Hi, my name is Austin McCormick. I am the pastor of Shepherd Baptist Church in Dixon, Missouri. I'm graduating with the Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies. I've been asked to speak for 5 minutes about the most important thing that I have learned during my studies at CBTS. And after reflecting upon this topic, I remembered three headings that Dr. Waldron shared with us in his lectures from Introduction to Systematic Theology and Apologetics. First, all true theological study must be chaste. Or as Dr. Waldron has said, the theologian must remember that he is a creature studying his creator. Second, all true theological study must be practical in its goal. And third, all true theological study must have for its goal the spiritual benefit of the student. Or in my own words now, the goal of theology is not to puff us up or to turn us into cold intellectuals. Theological study should help us to love the Lord our God with all our hearts, with all our souls, and with all our minds. So the most important thing that I have learned then can be summarized as follows. All of my theological training must be for the glory of God, for my spiritual good, and for the spiritual good of others in my church. Allow me to share some examples of how this has been actualized in my local church. Biblical theology and biblical hermeneutics have helped me to see the Bible as one overarching progressive story that points us to Jesus. As a result of my training, I can see Christ more clearly from the scriptures and especially from the Old Testament. Of course, this is spiritually good for me. This has also benefited my congregation as we have worked through Ecclesiastes, Ruth, and portions of the Psalter together. Our church, like many others, has had disputes about music. Before such disputes arose, I learned about Benjamin Keach in a course here. I was amazed that Baptists have been disputing about music, or we might say the lack thereof, and the types of music that can be sung in worship since the 17th century. I was thankful that I was not left to myself to think through this dispute. Gifted brothers from my theological tradition had thought through many of these issues before, so by the grace of God, the music disputes were resolved at our church, and I can say, historical theology has been used for my spiritual good. In Doctrine of the Church, I heard about the regulative principle of worship for the first time. I led my church to practice it. We replaced an awkward handshaking tradition with a New Testament scripture reading, and we replaced untimely announcements with an Old Testament scripture reading. This last Lord's Day, I overheard two of our church members talking about our worship services, and one of them said, "When we come to church, we have over an hour to think about God and worshiping Him alone. So the regulative principle of worship has been spiritually good for our membership." And lastly, in our Introduction to Evangelism course, we were given the assignment to write a gospel tract for our community. After giving this resource to my church, I noticed more of our memberships asking me to pray for the people that they have been sharing the gospel with in our community. And they also brought visitors with them to the assembly that I've never met before. So the collective goal of reaching the lost in our community with the gospel has been spiritually good for our church. When I began my journey to receive theological education, I was warned by a Christian about the dangers of what he called cemetery. I think he called it cemetery because of his experience of what we might call cold intellectualism, but I'm grateful to say that this has not been my experience at CBTS. The professors and administrative staff at CBTS have challenged me to examine myself spiritually, to consider my motives, and to do theology for the good of the people that I've been called to serve, and primarily for the glory of God. They are examples of warm, confessional Christianity that I look up to. Thank you to everyone at CBTS. Thank you to all of the church partners that have partnered with Covenant Baptist Theological Seminary. And thank you for all of the donors that have made theological education affordable and accessible. Thank you.
All right, now time to present the diplomas. First is Robert Austin McCormick, receiving his Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies. Good thing.